Oh, how would you like to climb back into the sack right now like that guy? Getting a good night's sleep is always important. But in these times of COVID, sleep plays an essential role in fighting off the virus. Sleep is also a must, we're hearing now, before receiving the COVID vaccination. Now, Dr. Joseph Ogile with the Clayton Sleep Institute joins us to explain the connection between sleep, COVID vaccination, and immunity. Hi, Joe. How are you?
Good morning, John. Thanks for having me on.
You always look like you're getting a good night's rest, and that's so important. Talk about how that's so important in boosting an immune system.
Well, one of the things we know, John, from many studies over the decades, is that one of the earliest identified benefits of sleep, or negatives if you don't get enough sleep, is a change in your immune system, the function of the cells and antibodies that affect your ability to fight off infection. And now with the onset of COVID, for going on a year, there's data starting to come out. The Academy of Sleep Medicine surveyed over 2,000 people and found that a third of them are having trouble with sleep quality, a third with sleep duration, and a third getting to sleep. So this is concerning as we go into this issue of vaccination. It's been shown in several studies over the last several years that people who don't get enough sleep prior to the flu, hepatitis A and B vaccines, do not have as brisk a response as those who have the proper amount of sleep duration and quality. So having good sleep, both duration and quality, is beneficial for the immune reaction to vaccination.
Well, right now, everybody seems to be in the same boat, trying to find out where we could even get the vaccine and when. Because there aren't that many doses out there. But when we do receive word, hey, you're going to get it next Friday, this isn't something you go, okay, I'm going to get a good night's sleep tonight. This is progressive, correct?
That is progressive. And again, I would encourage, you've been very great about encouraging our neighbors and friends and your viewers to incorporate sleep health as part of their daily habits. This is a prime reason why using the disaster in a sense of COVID in our society to try to turn it into a positive by focusing on some of these positive health activities. Another recent study that would suggest this as well is there was a big study done in New Zealand by colleagues over there that looked at over 1,000 people and found that sleep quality and sleep quantity were two predictive things in our life to help fend off depressive symptoms.
Yeah.
So you have the benefit of both being a better immune system and being more happy.
And we're talking about 7 to 8 hours of sleep each night.
For most people, they need 7.5 to 7 hours and 45 minutes a night. There is some variation by individual there because it's written into our genetic code when we're conceived. But by and large, that's the average for most folks. And if we shoot for a goal, and you can use your wake time to figure that out. The wake time is very important, as you know, is when you get up in the morning to get about 20 minutes of bright light. That will signal your brain that you should start to get ready for bed or get sleepy about 7.5 or 8 hours prior to that bright light. So, for instance, this morning, getting about 20 minutes of bright light, whether it's in front of your computer or with good lighting in your home, that'll tell your brain that you should be trying to go to bed about 11 o'clock or so if you're going to be getting up at 7 or 8 in the morning. Now, for most people, that's probably later than they get up, but everybody's got their own life walk, so to speak. For instance, you and Randy, given how early you have to get up, the bright light that you get when you come to work says you need to get to bed at, what, 8 o'clock?
Well, yeah, or 7 o'clock.
And
like
seven.
Sunday night watching the championship game, 9:30.
Exactly.
And I'm going to end it on this. You can never catch up, you said. That's the most important thing I've learned from you. You can't catch up on your sleep.
You can't.
No.
Right. And you can't cheat sleep. That's right, John.
All right. Dr. Ogile, thank you so much. So diet's important and exercise is important, but sleep is the most important out of those three, and we always learn that as well. We appreciate your time again, Doc.
Thank you, John. Have a great day today. You too.